Okay. このあと、このあとレクチャーやって、で30分後ぐらいにワーク始まるんですけども、ワーク中にちょっとあのポートレート写真を撮る予定になってますんで、一人一人あのこっそりって声かけて拉致しますから、あのちゃんとドレスアップしといてください今の。レクチャー中にドレスアップしといてください。
So we will ask each individual to come to take photo with us because you know we want the portrait of everyone because you know we will take a group photo later on but we want the portrait so that we know who came to the short course and you know you're one of us now you are part of the alumni you will be part of the alumni so we will take a photograph and then we will tap your shoulder okay during the workshop
okay let's get started again. Right. Well, business model and value proposition. What is business model? Business model's definition is also varied. There are a bunch of definitions. You look, read the 10 books, you can get 10 definitions. And this is shown, described on the book, Business Model Generation. How many of you guys have read this book? Oh, okay, thank you. A business model describes the rationale of how an organization creates, delivers, and captures value, right? Not too bad, not too bad. And there are so many business models in business history. The history of business is like, you know, history of business model innovation, right? Starting from original business in ancient ages, right? Or like, I know, Ichigo-ya とかね。そういうのも含めて。これはいいね。
エチゴヤ、
うん、okay. です。は東インド会社とかそういうのも含めて一つのビジネスモデルですよね。それはいらないですね。okay, then the we cannot go through every single business model, right? But we are gonna go a couple of business model, very major ones, right? Knowing current business model patterns.Will help you, okay, for getting some inspiration for your work on your business model, right? That some business models are a combination of existing business models, or it's created from the inspiration from existing business models. So knowing the existing business model patterns.Will help you, right?
Just one thing to add. So, okay. Like looking at CVCA can maybe recognize a business pattern. So maybe you know you can recall the CVCA you created yesterday may resemble some of the business model you see today.
Okay. Yeah. Yes. Right. Exactly. Right. The first one is multi-sided platforms. It's so popular these days. Like you know.American Express, Visa, Recruit, Google, and Grunabi or Tabelogo, and many things, right? This model offers different solutions to different platforms, right? So, and if there is for example, thatVisa has two platforms, right? One is card users, another is shops, right? Small shops and big shops. Recruit has recruiting companies and students want to get a job in one business in of them. Google has you know, two platforms or multiple platforms, searchers and companies want to push ad, right? So, they're connecting those two different platforms, they are getting, creating values to customers. But if there's no card users, completely no value for shops, right? So if you would take this business model, you should, you have to grow multiple platforms simultaneously. So weaker one is going to be the bottleneck of your business. So it is that making the growth on multiple platforms is quite important for this business model patterns, right?
One example we had was the Rentarokan. Rentarokan is absolutely about multi-sided platform, right? Because you need some okan to register or mom to register, and you need students to ask for that. So it's exactly the same.
Okay.
Yes. So it was Rentarokan.
Rentarokan. Yeah.
Yes. it evolved into Rental Grandma even.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. They evolved. Okay. That's great. Interesting. Right. As a long tail, it is very popular, right? You know it. Okay. The typical business model patterns of it's famous by Amazon, right? This is the distribution of number of products, items, and this is a sales volume by item, right? And this is the head, and this is tail, so-called tail. And before the internet, this shape was like this. And after internet, it became like this, right? Long tail. Without internet, it's quite difficult to do it because of physical limitation of stockyard or shelf space, okay? So, but virtually, we can have no limitation of stock shelf and showcase. Then, by using IT technique, if you can push good recommendation to users, you can enjoy sales from these long tails, right? So I don't think some of you are CBCA show the EC staff. No EC, right?
If EC, so you put it on the sale on the internet. Did anyone have that idea?
No.
Not yet, probably. Not yet, yes.
But if you would go to this, you definitely should enjoy this model patterns, okay? Right? And third one is bait and hook. Esa to tsuribari, ne? This is originally developed by Xerox, photocopy makers, and offers the basic products by low price, very low price, as ESA bait, and then taking profit from refills or associated products, right? So in the Xerox case, the bait ESA wa photocopy machine, yeah? And hook, tsuribari wa toner cartridge toka, ink toka, so you know, right? And in the, you know, this is also called the razor blade business model. Okay? This is a razor blade of Gillette, and this is tsuribari. And T-shaped shaver is ESA. It's sold by at the lower price and getting profit from razor blade, right? Okay, and third one is freemium. Premium. It is a kind of derivative of bait and hook. How many of you guys are using the Dropbox? Wow, more than 80% market share. How many of you guys are paying for Dropbox? See? Those people are paying for most of you, okay? And I pay. It's very good subs, right? And freemium means free plus premium. Give away a core product by free instead of lower price, by free. And got a big user base and picked the premium users who are paying for premium products. Okay, this is a derivative of Bait and Hook, right?
We actually pay everything. We like our instructors. We pay Dropbox, mm-hmm. we pay SugarSync, and we pay what? Skype, and we pay what? What else? Evernote.
Mm.
We are all premium users of all those services.
Yeah.
Yes. So we pay for you guys. You should appreciate us.
Yeah. Most of you guys are free riders. Right? Enjoy it. Okay. Yes. Thanks to them.
Yes. Yeah. All of us does.
Okay. So, no frills. This is the famous with Southwest Airlines, LCC, low cost carrier, and or QB House, 10 minutes cut. And this model removes non-essential features like the food or drinks or whatever, business class seat or something in the FCC case. And the QB cuts removes washing hairs and shaving, massaging, and so on, right? And concentrate on essential service products, right? And provide them to customers by very, very low price, okay? So its concept is very simple, but implementation is quite difficult, right? Because this model requires operational excellence. The service quality standardization and training for their employees. So it's not so easy. But once you build your operational excellence, it's gonna be a competitive advantage against existing players. So in case of Southwest Airlines, their turnover is very, very short time, right? It's realized by making every kind of employee to work on multitask. Even the pilot is gonna clean up shit, okay? It's quite difficult in major airlines because of union problem or something. And in QB House, they cut one customer's hair by 10 minutes. And for doing so, they invested on IT systems and investing on the same format for every outlet. So concept is simple, but execution is difficult. So demo ne, ano, dakara very sugoi kyoui nan desu yo, kizon no player ni totte wa. Dakara docchi mo kou no frill wo yaro to suru to kekkou ne, ano, regulation wo 上げようとしたりとか、なんかのそのロビーングをして叩き潰そうという動きが必ず起きるんですね。で、キュービーハウスなんかは知ってますかね。あの先発台がないでしょ。だけど、理髪業協会がすっごい政治にアプローチして、結局それを入れなければダメだっていうふうにしたんですね。だから今使われてない先発台が1個ずつある、必ずある。だけどそのコストをアコモデートしてもできるように今またインプルーブしてる。だこれぐらいやっぱり既存のプレイヤーに恐れられて何かそのレギュレーションを変えなければ太刀打ちできないと思われるぐらいのビジネスモデルのパワーがこの人たちあるということですよね。
So he just explained that no frills are there, they are the big threat to the authorities or the tradition companies because you know because, for example, QB House. You know QB House? Hoon, do you know QB House? No. It's a you can get a haircut by 10,000 yen, and it's 10-minute cut. And usually you pay like at least like, I don't know, 3,000 yen or 4,000 yen if you're a man, right? Maybe you pay for that, but you can pay just 1,000 yen. And so this is like super low cost, and it's super quick, and then it's a minimal service. And then it can take over a lot of customers from the traditional or conventional. So the conventional people do not like you, do not like this business. So they will put new regulations. They will ask for new regulations for the country or government. They will ask for new rules. So you want to become a threat like this. If you're an entrepreneur, you want to become a threat to the traditions and conventional. So that's what he wanted to point out.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Good. Good translator. Varying at. Okay. Thank you. So, any question? Okay, please.
Okay.
What do you mean by platform? I mean, there is no definition. And what, in other words, what the difference from the business area, 事業分野 to platform? What the difference?
Platform
here.
Let me explain in Japanese. Platform は事業分野とかっていう意味ではなくて、ある種のそのユーザーの一つの塊ですね。例えば、このレンタルおかんだとおかんの塊、おかんの塊ズプラットフォームでね。それからそれをこう借りる人の塊で、その人たちにアプローチしなきゃいけない。それぞれアプローチするっていう、そのアプローチする、そのネットワークにアプローチするっていう、そのケーパビリティはその会社が持ってなきゃいけないことですけど、おかんに対してビジネスをやるっていうわけじゃなくて、おかんとそれを借りる人をつなげることでビジネスのバリューが初めて生まれるわけです。だから事業分野ではない。ある種の、まあ、カスタマーの塊。Does it make sense?
So the question was, what is a platform? So platform is not about ITC or anything like that, but it is a group of customers or cluster, the big, huge chunk of customers. So for example, like Visa case. Visa, so the shops that put the Visa machine, they set the Visa machine, that's your one of the platforms. And then the other one is the shoppers. So you need two or more platforms to be able to, and what you make money out of it is you connect these two platforms or multiple platforms. That's your business. So the platform is not a system, like an IT system, but it's a group of customers.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Any question?
Sure.
カスタマーとかの塊ではなくて、それをコネクトする機能がないとプラットフォームとは言えないっていう理解でいいですか？
そうです。Exactly.
あ、わかりました。ありがとうございます。
Any questions?
Okay. I have a question about no-frill business models. I think low cost does not simply means low services or less services or low quality. I think actually their business model provides their service with a variety of choices, in other words, flexibility. For example, when we take low-cost carrier, mm-hmm. We can buy foods by paying, or we can have blanket mm-hmm. by paying some amount of money.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So in my opinion, low cost does not simply means a low quality of service.
Exactly.
Is it correct?
Yes, exactly, yes. It's not mean to reduce quality of service by lowering cost. It doesn't mean to it, right? You are right. Okay.
But you know, you can focus on no frill, furiru, hirahira ga tsuite nai itte imi. So no bells and whistles. So no fancy stuff. No like excessive quality. The minimum but good quality. So that's what this no frill means. Furiru ga tsuite nai. But it still works as a close. It's good as a close.
And you should focus on core product or core service, and don't lower your quality on core products or service.
Right.
So defining what is core products or service is very important. To
I understand. Thank you.
Thank you. Any question? Okay. So, okay, please.
Getting interesting. Good.
Yeah.
Yes.
Sorry. I have a question. On you're talking before Blake, because so in slide number 18 you talked about the super high volatility.
Oh yes.
But could you give an example about it? Like what is super high volatility?
Yes. In small startups,
do you know what volatility means?
Like
volatile.
Yeah, I know.
Up and down. It's like high freaking up and down. Okay, good.
The starting business that whether it is not sure whether customers will appreciate our value. Whether customers will pay for the products or service continuously, whether we can produce the products and service in constantly. Anything is uncertain comparing existing business, right? In existing business, those kind of things are far more certain, okay? They have existing customers, they have existing resources for producing products or services, they have track record with existing users, customers. So in that is only a couple of examples, but you know, in many cases for small startups that it's not sure whether we are going to realize our plan or our vision comparing the existing players, right? So in that sense, that uncertainty plus uncertainty, not plus, times uncertainty. So the result, outcome is going to be highly volatile, right?
Think about the very different variables, right? Different hensu for your business. And you're multiplying all of them to get the outcome. The big companies, they are sure about these numbers, right? But you are starting up. Every number is uncertain or unknown. So, and then it can go up and down. So if you multiply them, the errors or volatility propagates and it expands.
I mean, it depends on the number of variables. Is it the variable number is pretty low? There, it gonna become the low volatile. Then on the other hand, the super high volatility means like there are so many variables.
No,
is it correct?
No. Not for the number of variables, but uncertainty in each variable. Okay. So we have variable 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like you know, operation or customers' appreciation or whatever. And existing business and new startup. Number of variable doesn't matter, right? So in these cases, this is certain, right? Uncertain. And same. Times, and outcome is very highly volatile in here. So not the number of variables, but uncertainty or sureness in each variable. Does it make sense?
Yeah, I got it. Yeah, thank you so much.
Okay, thank you.
Can you explain the niche?
Oh, okay.
The niche products by a short words.
For the.
The Amazon long case. Tail? Amazon case.
Yes. This is.
And also, not clear on the diagram why the number of the products is increased, but the sales performance getting reduced. Why?
Sorry, but okay, I got it.
Thank you.
Well, this is niche. Yes, niche is niche. どう言えばいいかな?
Yeah, niche. Okay, niche is like it's rare. Okay, but you have like a core hardcore fan. For example, like supercars, like Ferrari, right? It's like you don't see Ferrari often, right? But there are some group of people who really loves Ferrari. Do you know Ferrari? Do you have one? it's a car that's like super expensive from Italy. Yes, the horse. Yes. You want to get a boyfriend who's on a Ferrari. That's for sure. But Ferrari is a niche market, right? Because people are not buying Ferrari. So it's a small market. But there is a hardcore fan or hardcore customers that exist, okay? So that's that. So you call it niche market. Instead, like Toyota sells a mass production or for more mass acknowledged or appreciated cars. That's a market, right? That's a big market. And that's a comparison between from niche market and in the market, okay?
The special products it's only for the target small group
yes.
customer.
Yes, exactly, okay. Right.
Yes, right. And as for this, this is a product item, right?
Different category.
Or a book, one by one, right? This is a distribution of the number of copies in each book item, okay? So this one is a top seller.
Like One Piece.
One Piece, right?
Do you know One Piece?
One Piece?
Yeah, it's a manga.
Anime. One Piece.
Anime. Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. It sold a bunch of copies.
Yeah.
So it's ranked in here. And design management, no. What a saying. Eh?
it's his book.
No.
His book is far off the chart.
No. It was ranked at number one at the business category, right?
Yes.
So it was here, not niche market. And partnership management is in here, right? So this is items, right? So that. Does that make sense?
Okay.
And you, because of the internet or EC, it's now very easy to handle these product. Because before, if you were just sitting there and selling books, it's stupid to get these books and put it on the shelf.
Yeah, stupid to get my books in the shelf, right?
Because it's not gonna sell
it's
well.
Oh, okay. Yes,
but you didn't buy.
It's smart action. Yeah.
Yes, but you didn't buy, right? So that's what that's really what we're talking about because
you're not buying.
And so if many people are not buying, then we're not going to sell it at the shelf. But internet, because it's low cost to keep the inventory, right? So that's why now these products are sold more often and more frequently. So now this tail became so long that you can buy craziest niche stuff online. Like you buy it secretly at night, right? You buy crazy stuff. So that's that.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any further questions, please? Wow, I love questions. It's interesting.
Okay, so I have a question about also about the just the long tail business model, and yes, I think the niche the product make a many profit when the lineup is varied. Mm-hmm. But I think the demand prediction of the niche users and niche product is very difficult.
Mm-hmm.
So do you have any idea about how we expand and our lineup or categories of the product or service to the niche users? Do you have any ideas?
Do you imagine the in a certain business when
yes.
you came up with that question?
Yes, e-commerce.
E-commerce.
Yes.
Which what kind? Book.
Okay. So the book.
Yes. Demand prediction is quite difficult. The accurate prediction is impossible, totally impossible. So they're gonna expand their product or item lines by small amount by each item, okay? And then connect their new expanded item to their algorithm for producing some recommend to their existing customers and do it and check it and test and verificate and once the outcome is not good, they're gonna eliminate the item, right? So accurate prediction is impossible. So you should forget about it. But don't put much money on newly extended item at the very first point, right? Does it make sense?
Yeah, so it's an iteration, yes.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Arigato. Thank you.
Biden hook business model.
Okay.
I think the other company can make other toner cartridge,
yes.
which can suitable, yeah, for right. that. Yeah, so how do they protect their product from such third parties? Do they get a patent before they start business?
Yeah, exactly. So yeah, so it doesn't work for commodity, like you know the stapler. If you wanna sell the staplers. Needle by higher price, it doesn't work. Yeah.
So is to get patent the only way to protect their business?
Well, not only the getting patent, but also they are getting the make the connection between the bait and hook special. And so that other players don't want to apply for that connection system.
And in other words, you tweak around the interface. So you have a special interface mm-hmm. in between hook and then the bait,
so that other third party cannot join or do not want to join, because there are too much, you know, cost to adjust to that crazy interface, so to say. Yes.
Yes. And in some cases, the patent doesn't work, or patent is eliminated, terminated. In that case, they are using the other ways to protect, such as giving the special after service, and the users can only enjoy the full performance by using their after service, right?
And I think some customers may think they want genuine like toner cartridge mm-hmm. from Xerox, like, so we can think how we can make customers mm-hmm. feel so.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Great question. Okay. Thank you.
I worked for printer company, so I can add some. Recently, printer company is very struggling to keep their benefit because.
Yeah.
Especially in developing country, there are many companies mm-hmm. who sell copies. And so recently, Epson stopped this business model.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
they are trying to make the printer more expensive, and then they try to get profit from printer by itself because they cannot stop them to buy copying.
Mm. Great. Thank you. Yes.
The imitated products, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Yes.
Actually, I'm buying the imitation for my printer. Yes,
really?
Thank you. Great.
Okay.
Great comment. Any questions? Yes.
I think I have just comments for this Biden Fook product. And I think the printer companies are struggling now, but I think Apple's iPhone model is their new version, new derivable business model,
mm-hmm,
because
mm-hmm.
They made competitors like application makers make them as a slave or colleague. We can say that. So if Xerox can prepare some platforms to make some cartridges for them and make them use, and
mm-hmm.
that is the same, I think, business model.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Just comment.
Mm. Thank you. That's a great comment. All right. Any further questions or comments on it? All right. Okay, thanks for many comments. I appreciate it. That's great.
We're taking notes, so.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you. All right. Next, let's get into the business model canvas. So, how many of you guys have used the business model canvas before? 20%, 30%, okay?
How many of you know business model canvas? Know or heard about? About half.
Okay, you used? All right. Can you share your experience? No? Not that much.
I'm in the laboratory of service design, so
okay.
I used it in my seminar.
All right.
Yeah, just it.
Okay,
yeah.
Thank you.
How did it go?
It was too difficult for just 20 years old around person,
mm-hmm.
so it didn't work much. But I thought it was very useful
mm-hmm.
to clear our brain.
Mm-hmm. Have a great experience of using the good experience of using this to be shared.
Your question.
Mm-hmm.
I use this business model canvas from our business team, and I think it's a little bit, we had a very difficulty to use all this these models canvas, because we need if I try to make a cost structure about that,
mm-hmm.
so we need to another strategy or method like 3P something or CFS something,
yeah.
like MBS,
yeah.
the guy studied that. So in each district, like our value proposition, mm-hmm. we need our CVCL, something like that, and customers, so we need something method. So is that right? My understanding is right?
Yeah. Yeah. Each building blocks, you need to have some, the deep thought on it. So just filling out each building block is easy. But after that, we came up with so what situation. So what on this? That is so-called SWOT. So what on this? Wow, we feel that. Okay. What, right? So this is just a tool. This is just a tool.
Or visual representation.
Yeah.
Just visual aid to show your business model.
Mm. So it cannot create any great business model by itself. Mm. You can create great business model by using this, mm. right? So just filling out is very easy. Mm. Just sharing it is very easy, mm. but really utilizing it is quite, there are some gap between that.
Right.
That is knowing, doing gap, or filling, utilizing gap. Right?
Yeah, because the name explains itself. Business model canvas, right? So if you're a painter, you need to know what to draw, because this is just a canvas. You cannot just stare at the canvas and say, hey, I'm getting a picture. No, you don't do that.
Mm.
It's a canvas that you can draw, and it's canvas with a line so that you can draw better. So you need to know what to draw.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
So the business model canvas is a communication tool for describing, visualizing, assessing, and improving business model, right? It doesn't create any business model by itself. It's a communication tool. And using this, it's easy to collaborate with teammates and easy to look at the grants on the one page. So it's great. It's great. But it's not magic tool. It's not magic tool. And also, some people say, blaming the business model canvas as it's totally useless, but it's not correct. It's not correct attitude against any tool, okay? So today, we are not work on business model canvas. We don't have such sufficient time, but we are going to focus on only one or two segments later on, okay? And right, let me skip the explanation of each building block quickly. This is customer segment, describing your business models, customer groups, and value proposition. It's very, 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 very much important for your business. Describes the handle. The products and service that creates value for a specific customer segment. We are gonna work on this later, okay? And this is a delivery channel. It describes how you communicate this value to customers. And relationship, this describes the relationship you are gonna build with your customers. It's also important, right? And revenue streams, how much revenue or getting from and how got from the customers. For doing this in a very high quality, you need knowledge about the managerial accounting and finance, unit economics, things like that, right? So we are gonna talk the unit economics and managerial accounting later. That could be useful these segments later, okay? And key resources is important asset for doing your business, right? And key activities is important activities you are gonna do for producing value proposition to customers. And partnerships outside of your company, right? For supplementing your resources, right? For building your value proposition. And cost structure. This is also, you know, the needs knowledge about the managerial accounting, finance stuff, right? That is the brief, very brief explanation of business model canvas. But in whole canvas, maybe we are going to work on day 6 or 7 or something.
Day seven.
Right? Okay. Today we are going to.
That's a joke. We're end today. Okay. So, but we can. Hajiki-san, do you recommend if you don't know any business, if you're a student, is it a good book to read? Understand the overview of the business scope, do you think? To know about each segment?
Okay. The business model generation. Business model generation is describing the how to use this business model canvas. Well, I have the book today, but it's in the suitcase, maybe. So I'm gonna pick it. You have? Okay.
Yeah, we'll get it for you.
Yeah.
So it's a good book to read if you don't, if you're like student, if you have no experience in business, you know, you can you know different viewpoints of the business. So it's a good book to for you to start to learn, I guess. Yeah. But it doesn't generate anything. It's just, you know, different viewpoints explained.
Right. Okay. And among them, we are gonna focus on this value proposition and customer segment from now. Well, yes, we've reached to the first exercise for taking your portfolio pictures. Okay, ready for it? All right. Okay, let's do exercise. Well, all right. You guys are sitting in the table, a different table from yesterday, right? The different groups. Different groups, okay? So, I want to share your excuse me. これってそれぞれはその CBCA は全部テーブルに紐づいてるんです。Okay.
Because we at least we have 6 CBCAs, so okay. And we have 6 tables, so you can choose whatever yours.
All right.
And, but we want at least one person who understands that CBCA.
Right, right.
Okay. But it's gonna be fun to understand other CBCA and think about it, right? Okay.
There are chief CBCA officer in
yes, okay.
each table, yeah. right?
CCO.
CCO.
Yes, CCO.
CCO should have responsibility to make a briefing to other
okay,
team
let's
members.
Let's make a
okay?
decision. Okay, from this team, where is your CBCA? Maybe in the other, the back. I want one CCO from this team. Just raise your hand. One CCO who sit here yesterday, I guess. That's, what is it? This is Motoki's team, I guess, isn't it?
Kenko Jihanki.
Yeah, Kenko Jihanki. I want one CBCA officer. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, then you are my CCO. All right? So you're responsible for, your team is responsible. And I want one from the tableware, actually. Yes, tableware. One CBCA officer. Oh. Okay, then Ayano. Okay, you're officer. And one for... What was it? Was it energy or yes? Okay. All right, who wants to be a CCO? Amy, you're CCO now. Good. All right, and then, what was the that one? I can't recall. What's that? Oh, DIY house. Okay, DIY house, CVCA officer. Okay, you're one. And then Lentaro Khan. Okay, so Misato, you're CVCA officer. All right. Do we have all the officers in the table? No. Oh yeah, last one. Okay.
Kasamashi Shoki.
Is anyone Kasamashi Shoki person? Different. Okay, we're gonna get Kasamashi officer here. Let's see. Okay. All right. Yasu, why don't you come over here? Because I know you're Kasamashi Shoki person, right? Oh, you have one?
No,
not yet. Okay. Oh, okay. So you can be that, right? Kasamashi Shoki. Yeah. Right. Akari, you can be a CBC officer, right? Who understands? So where is one more? Where is one more?
Two, right? So we have two officers
right here. Oh, okay. Oh, right. So we need one per table. So maybe, I don't know, why don't you come over here and join this team with your CVC because you have officer already. Okay, good. Okay, so one table has one CVCA officer and then with one CVCA.
Okay, bring your CVCA to your table and make a briefing to other teammates.
Right. So right. CVCA officers, go get your CVCAs. It's okay. As long as you guys are okay. Yeah? Lonely? Scary?
Okay, you pick your CVCA. Right? After doing briefing, you are going to work on this. On your CVCA. Make customer profile. And select one customer segment you want to profile for that CVCA. Select one customer profile. Customer segment, that is the most important customer segment for your business, okay? And step into your customer's shoes and feel as if you were them, right? Feel. And identify customers' pains. What pains do your customers have? Feel it, okay? Have empathy for them, right? Many annoying things, problems, obstacles, risks, many things, okay? And identify customers' gains. What do your customers want to achieve, right? Feel it. Don't think, feel, okay? Right? Then write down onto your sticky notes, okay? Like this. Pains and gains. これ、実際に我々がやったやつなんですけども、ある、スポーツトレーナー、アスレチックトレーナーのペインとゲインをやろうと言って、まあ、その時は我々そのエンパシーを感じるというか、一人その中にアスレチックトレーナーが入ってたんで、まあ、かなり泣きながらやったんですけど、途中で結局誰か死んじゃうとかっていうことが、この間羽生さんの、頭を打っちゃってっていうようなことがありましたけど、ああいうような事例とかがあったりとか、あとは、まあ、とにかく忙しいんだと、もうアスレチックトレーナーの仕事は本来これなのに、なんかいろんな雑もやんなきゃいけない、集計しなきゃいけない、すぐ出さなきゃいけない、だけど なんかお前もう何か起きたらお前責任取れよみたいな感じで全然アプレシエートされてる気がしないみたいなこととか、こういうことをできるだけ我が事として自分事として感じて書き出していってください。 OK?
So this is one example from actual his project. He listed up, they listed up there as a team pains and gains for their customers. Okay, so this is what you want to do, what we want you to do. So you put your foot in the customer's shoes. This is a very American way to put it, but be and act and think like him or her. And then list up all the gains, that's something you want, right? You want to get, and then pains, that's something you want to resolve, right? Okay?
Okay.
Yes, Nobby.
Do you have any clear definition between pains and gains? If I say I have no time, it's pains. Mm-hmm. But I have much time and I don't have time, and I solve my time problem, it's gains. So, which do you have any idea? Which is which?
Yes. In some case, the coin の裏表になる。
Yeah.
だけどできるだけそのゲインの方はより具体的にどういう状態になりたいか、もう時間がなくてしょうがねえんだっていうのはペインでいいですけど、その時にゲインはそれ時間が欲しいっていうことがゲインじゃなくて、時間があったら何かしたいわけですね。絶対それはなんか満ち足りた感じになりたいのかもしれないし、もっと豊かな生活したいのかもしれないし、もっとクリエイティブなことやりたいのかもしれない、そういうところにゲインでは行ってほしい。
So when you're writing gain, I want you to try to be concreteor you know, visible as possible. So not just like abstract gain, but instead be a little bit more concrete. Like how do you become? How do you want to become? How, like what kind of happiness do you want to achieve? So you know, try to be a little bit more concrete than your pain points probably.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
How much time do we want to give them?
30 minutes.
Okay.
Right.
All right.
All right.
So decide on your customer, okay, and then customer profile, and then start doing this sticky note pains and gains thing.
Right. Start your working. Right.
Sorry,
listen, I woke you up.
Yeah, and I want to say it's so build a community. So it's for community because people gather, that's possible. And then, this is the actual project I was thinking about. And then, so let me say that the neighbors of the local community is for the, for the design of the materials. So here, so first we have a university.Makers. I mean, this is a certain point that will be overlapping. They have their desire or wish to what to make. They give up the dollars. And then at the same time, the local community pays for the design. So the supplier money. And then the material supplier gives out the materials tools to make the building.And then they will actually give up manpower in the site, and also to build the actual real estate. And there's also a structural engineer who authorized the drawings reality, because you know, these structural problems, it has to be like not just a cartoon, but an actual building. So the system. But I think this is a...Here, there's a CDCA. Do you have any questions?
Yes, so that is from the photo, the funny user should be the
green. Yes, yes. For example, what I was doing was that it's a building community that's in the disaster area and it's a fisheries community.The fishermen, they all live in the temporary houses supplied by the country. But they have no community space together. So they said that they want that kind of building. So we designed a building that can be buildable by the fishermen. They know, they have a skill of using large cranes or, you know, and they're very powerful friends. So basically, they were the landowners and also the engineers and also the maker of the house. So that's, I think you can ignore to make it simple. Yeah. And then the main engagement of them, I think, of the users is
we should announce really clearly like after our product really they gain what like they can save their lives or something like that.
From one.
Camera, you take your place.
Oh, they come here from
outside, outside.
I know most of you are working on painting games, but don't forget, okay, I want your attention. So don't forget, put your foot in the customer's shoes, okay? Set your mindset on the customer profile, and then put your legs or toes or whatever foot in the customer's shoes. So act and behave and think like your customer. Not you, okay? Your customer, okay? That's good? All right.
I think we have to
Thank you. Okay, you have 10 minutes more, 10 minutes to go.
はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい、もう一回。はい How to make Let's change it in better.
Okay, it's time. It's time to share. It's time to share. Okay? All right.
How did it go? So, any team want to share with others? Volunteer. Okay.
So,
our team discuss about the Simas Cha Ochawan. Kasamashi Chawan. Yeah. Yeah, same product, but yeah. We talking about our Kasamashi Chawan is maybe a little bit different from your team. Maybe. So that can be give a value to the enjoy the eating food or having food, and so the so we discuss maybe pains are it's hard diet is so hard to keep on it or for example scary to step on the weight meter or some
scale.
Yeah scale or yeah scary to take a photo mm-hmm. and gain is also enjoy the life like fashion or enjoy to talk during having food
mm-hmm.
and just like that.
Okay. So what kind of customer image did you have?
So
is it male, female?
Yeah, we
We define the customer as the people who are struggling to get to reduce the weight. It's
okay.
Clearly broad. It's not defined. We not define like a man, male,
okay.
Not female,
demographic.
No, yeah,
okay.
Or even the age or.
Right.
Who
yeah.
are a little concerned on their weight?
Oh yeah, exactly. Especially the weight.
First one is people who want to start diet but cannot start diet, and the second one is that who started diet but suffer in the diet.
Mm-hmm.
So we have two types of customers. We concern in this pains and gains chart.
Right. All you guys look so skinny, right? No. could you feel empathy on the customers? Really?
Yeah.
Sure.
when I was 5 kilograms,
yeah.
I want to
be better.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm.
So it's
that's
you.
Good. Good. Good.
Yeah. Because we want you to empathize. This is where you can apply your design thinking stuff. Okay. Because design thinking stuff does not come explicit. Okay. You can do design thinking stuff anywhere.
Right.
Right? So this is a great chance for you to empathize. Like we learn in the, like you can learn in the design thinking, you know, methodology books. This is where you do that. So, yeah. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Good.
Good. Great.
Thank you. Okay.
So, before we start our, this is another site, the pay and the gain, and I want to introduce our business model about the renewable energy popularize. It's just a company buy or land the field, and then they buy the renewable electricity or the equipment from the manufacturing company, for example, the solar panel, and then they sell the electricity to the electricity company,
mm-hmm.
and they get the money back, and then the electricity company will sell the electricity to the customer, and the customer is the energy consumer. Consumer is includes the citizens and the companies, and the this industry use and the individual the people use,
mm-hmm.
and then the government in order to popularize the renewable energy, they issue some related policy like the electricity fee and plus some extra tax for the popularize the renewable energy. So our analysis is for citizen people, what the pain and what the gain, and for company, what's the pain and the gain. And actually, this is not only our image. This is a big trend in Japan from 2020. For 2010, it will be happen. And from in other country, for example, the Germany, America, England, France, from 2000 year, they have already their electricity fee has appeared this 2000 year, and they appear like this. So now is 2014, and the Japan is government is considering to study from the other country like Germany, America, some for popularize their renewable energy. This is a big trend in the future, and this is a business model is a big trend in the future. So, okay, I will let our member and to introduce our the thinking way of their gain and pain.
Okay, Chimpray.
Okay, I divided our customer into two parts. Mm-hmm. One group is citizens, ordinary citizens, and the other is companies. So I'd like to explain pains and gains of companies about our new business. Mm-hmm. So the gains are maybe the company can gain financial aid from the government because this company contributes for the country's environment improvements. And the other is also social image for among people, because also it is very good image that the company works for environmental improvement. And also the pain, the company maybe have need to pay a huge amount of money to introduce this system at first, but maybe this will cultivate this new business, and if the business expand, the cost will be lower and lower. And second, the stability. Maybe first, since this system is new, the energy supplying stability is not so stable. Mm-hmm. But in the future, having multiple choices for energy is very good, because, for example, we experienced a huge earthquake in Tohoku region, and of course, there are a lot of electric errors. So, having multiple energy source is very important to improve its safe, its stability. Mm-hmm. And third point is about their future profit. Even though the new uncertain relationship is risky at first, but in the future, maybe there would be a chance for new investment. Like if we want to expand our business, we need investment, and this company can gain a lot of profit from our expansion of business. So. Mm-hmm.
So for the customer part, it means the citizens who live the area, and for the pain, it's like extra energy cost. Like in normally, the electricity cost is like, so for example, 100 yen, but okay 20 yen, but it's renewable sources. It costs a lot of. Lot of money to generate electricity, so it's like 40 yen or 50 yen. So it's paying for the people live there. And the second one is that like if the company construct new power plant, it use the land at the area, so maybe the price of resident will be decreasing. And for the gain is that better clean environment. So like, so the it uses renewable energy sources, so it doesn't emit any CO2 or other toxic. Yeah, and so if the people can get clean air or good environment. And so it's kind of possibility, but in the future, the renewable sources will be getting more and more popular, and the electricity cost will be lower. That's okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
So you did
the work on citizen and corporate in the same time or one by one? Same time, all right. Was it easy to do that, or hard to feel that there?
The beginning must be very difficult because it's the issue of money.
Uh-huh.
So the people do not want to mm-hmm. to pay more money mm-hmm. than in euro.
No,
so it's neither.
We're kind of interested in like how you. Yeah, I'm interested in the content, but we're interested in how you approach this. So mm-hmm. when you were putting the post-it notes, were you like doing let's do citizen first and then do company, or was it at the same time?
At the beginning, we do it at the same time.
Yeah.
But okay.
After that, we divide it in two groups.
Oh, two groups.
Great.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Great. Well.
Wow. Do we imagine the woman? She is 23 years old, fit ready, and loves cakes and likes cute clothing. Yeah. And
do we okay paints?
You are talking about the.
The Kasamashi Shoki.
Another
Kasamashi Shoki.
Yeah, Kasamashi Shoki. Short word in English, please.
Personal? Good plate. Healthy plate? No? Okay, healthy plate, yes. Okay, healthy plate.
Nice
okay.
Well, first, we didn't. We had a problem trying to. Share the image of the user. That's why we decided to put some imaginary user who are supposed to be typical user and our target, which can be whoever that is kind of office ladies and the height and weight is also very typical.
Normal shape, yeah. And we introduce paint. Okay. In summer, maybe she has some so maybe she don't want to go see.
Extra weight.
Yes, weight. So and in summer she cannot wear no sleeves because she has extra weight around here. Yeah. Poyo poyo around here. and when she sit in the chair, poyo poyo here. So she feel bad. And when she loves cakes, but when she wants to buy cakes, but yeah, she can't buy this cake because she, we want to reduce her weight. The other gains? Ah, yes, this is really good point. So, okay, because, okay.
why I'm coming back? Oh, she, the fact is, you don't want to look that you are trying to go on diet. The key is you want to look effortlessly beautiful.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Right, right.
And that's the point that we're trying to write on the games, right?
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. Thanks so much.
Yeah, great insight.
That's a great insight that you empathize, or maybe you
because that you had some ladies that are similar to her, that you can empathize. But building the empathy is really, really important. That we wanted to focus here. We wanted you to try to focus. It's not about analysis. It's about empathizing and trying to feel their gains and pains, and not maybe a little bit of thinking, but a lot of feeling. Yes.
Yeah. Thank you. Thanks so much. So, as Ishibashi-san said, on this work, the feeling empathy for your customers is very important, very important. If you could not feel any empathy for them, you should not work on that business, right? Right? It's going to be unhappy situation for you and customers and everyone, okay?
We sometimes get, you know, since we do design thinking stuff, right? We sometimes get this question, how can we empathize our customer? If you can't, don't do that business. That's, you know, that's, I think that's the truth. If you cannot empathize your, what you're trying to do to your customer, maybe you should move into different domain, different business. That's yeah. How we agree on.
Okay.
So could you tell me, how did you feel the empathy for the Osoro's customer?
Yes, I'm man, and our major customer segments are female, but I'm cooking, and my wife is doing business by herself, so she's so busy every day, so I was watching her situation. And on top of that, we did a bunch of observation using the system kitchen maker's showroom and invited many users in there and asked them to do cooking and observed them and did interviews and eating cakes and drinking teas. They said many, many pains to us, right? So very beginning of the project, we had less empathy on it. That was only the based on our individual's experience. I had certain empathy on them, but some guy didn't have any empathy on them. But after that observation, interviewing, and focus group interview, in-depth interview, again and again and again, and we shared empathy between among the group of team, right? Does it make sense? Thank you. Any question further? Okay, so in case you'd have multiple customer segments like that group, focus on one segment at same time, right? That would be better. But you came up with that conclusion after working for two segments simultaneously. That is more important than learning by reading this, okay? That is your insight by doing, okay? That is far more important, okay? So if you would have multiple segment, customer segment, focus on one segment because we are not so smart to be able to imagine empathy on multiple segment at one time, okay? So focus on one segment. Step into the customer's shoes. Feel their pain and gains as if those pains and gains are yours, okay? And feel their unmet needs. For doing that, you should focus on one segment at one time, okay? And if, as Ishibashi-san said, if you cannot feel any empathy on it, is there anyone who could not feel empathy on the customer in this work? It's possible, yes. You can be honest, right? If you cannot feel any empathy, be honest and don't put your effort on that project further, okay? In that case, you can do pivot, right? You see pivot? you can change your direction of your business to another way, right?
Of course, you've done a lot of things.
Yes, yes.
Of course, you, after you tried and tried, and you still feel that you're missing empathy, then it's, I guess it's a great timing to think about the pivoting, you know, thinking about repurposing, changing your directions.
Yeah. Okay.
You said that you need to focus on a segment at one time, but do we need to think about the interaction between segments? Because maybe sometimes that interaction can affect in your customer
sure.
gain
sure.
or pain.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. That the if the interaction between multiple customer segment is important, you for fulfilling your empathy, focus on one segment. For fulfilling your empathy on another segment, focus on one segment. And by focusing on one segment, it even in the you are focusing on one segment, you are feeling some interaction with another customer segment, right? Not it's not. Can I?
Yeah, it's not explicitly discussed. However, but if you have done one empathy on one segment first, and then the second segment, you still have this experience. So it's gonna be integrated or connected, whenever you're trying. So you can maybe go back and forth, back and forth.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. Right. Great.
I'm feeling empathy on him, so I can understand what he's trying to say.
When you say segment, mm-hmm. how concrete is it? For example, in Bibit, my company, mm-hmm. When we think about user, we imagine one man. So very concretely, I imagine the person. But what do you mean your segment? How concrete is it?
Segment is not a persona, no mm. persona. It's a customer groups. Mm. In traditional way, we cut market into segment based on demographic yeah. Factors like you know, male and female, age, income, or whatever.
Yeah.
But you know, not we can make the segments based on. Other many other factors that is very important for your business, mm. right? That's there is no absolute answer to be to split market into segments, but for working on this, the segment is not one persona of concrete one customer, right?
But when you think of, for example, gain and pain,
uh-huh.
How do you think of this?
Okay, like okay, yeah. So once we picked up the customer segments, mm. you can imagine a certain person in your brain, mm. inside your brain, right? Mm. So as I imagined my wife's situation,
wow.
or as I imagined the prospective customer's face and mode. So you can imagine the one concrete person's characteristics or face or situation inside your brain, right?
Okay. Maybe then same, almost same with us.
Mm, yes, yes, right.
In the process, it's very similar because, but we're just calling it segment because, you know, since we're not just focusing on one person, instead we're focusing on the group of people who has similar characteristics, but whenever you're trying to, you know, put a sticky note out, you will probably have someone in your mind that you're kind of imagining as a one of part of a segment.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so that's how it should operate. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you.
Any other questions?
Okay, so in case we have
multiple segments, customer segments, or as multiple stakeholders, such as multi-sided platform.
Right.
And in case of empathy mm-hmm. on them, mm-hmm. conflict with each other. Mm-hmm. How do we overcome the conflict? If you have any experience, could you tell me your solution?
Great question. Based on my experience.
Yes, I think it is very difficult, and there is no single answer. Mm. But if you have any experience, please tell me.
Yeah. Let me think. Well, sometimes there is a little conflict with multiple customer segments. In the Narumi's case, the most important customer segment is end users, and another is intermediate players or department stores. And in sometimes their interests are conflict, but it's a little conflict, not a conflict. So if you'd have some どうしようもないコンフリクトだったらどうしようもないですよね。それやるわけにいかないじゃないですか。どっちかハッピーにしてどっちかアンハッピーにするわけにいかないんで。で、多くの場合は我々もそうだと思いますけど、そうだったと思いますけど、その両者をあらゆるものはそうだと思うんですけど、すべてを一つの方法で満たすことはできないけども、でもその矛盾を何とかして使用したいというかアウフヘーベンしたいという、それがビジネスだったりとかイノベーションだったりしますよね。だからこの一見ちょっとコンフリクトするこの2つのカスタマーセグメントを同じイノベーティブなプロダクトを提供することによってどちらのベネフィットもそれを上回るレベルでやるというのがまああれだと思いますよね。正しい方向性だと思いますよね。でそれがもし本当にできないというぐらいの決定的なコンフリクトなんだとしたら、それはやるべきじゃないだと思います。
So based on his experience, so when you see a conflict, it appears to be a conflict. However, if you take a closer look or better look or different angle, look from the different angle, you might find an innovative solution. So that it won't look like a conflict. It will become a new solution solving or avoiding that conflict and then giving them a new value with a new problem set. So that's what from his experience. Yes, there are smaller conflicts that's happened, but whenever his team sees that, he tried to think of that from a different angle and find an innovative solution so that conflict is no more conflict.
That's a great question. Thank you.
ありがとうございます. Thank you.
About the empathy, I just want to share one experience of myself. And yes, I also wondering with the empathy, how can I find the empathy with the customer I'm doing research. And I think you must be stand on the same position as your customer. For example, if you're studying on the research of Minami Soma, because the 311, the big earthquake, and everybody is now is just try to find a way to help them reconstruct the place. Someone says have the proposal like to help them to develop the agriculture and to prove. Okay, this place to plant the vegetable and the fruits is safe for other people, but we haven't stand on the same position as the people live in Minami Soma. So we have to move there, maybe 1 month, and to real feel the people live here, what they are thinking about. Maybe they don't want to plant the vegetable, and they even don't want to live there. So we cannot pursue them to live there and to develop the agriculture. So just my thinking about how to create or how to find the empathy with our customer.
Definitely, definitely. That's, yeah, there are so many approaches that you should take. And then like he said, a lot of observation, a lot of interviews, or a lot of doing and actually feeling. So empathy is just a word, but empathy that happens here, or, you know, here. So you really have to do it to get it.
Okay, all right, let's take a lunch break. Okay, 1 hour, come back to here at 1 o'clock, right? Okay, so see you at 1 o'clock.
One thing, okay, let's take a group photo because it's nice outside today. So let's take it now and then have a lunch. Where should we go? Oh, we're going under the Ichō Namiki, the road, so that it looks better. So pack up for lunch, and then we're gonna go stop by on your way to lunch, and then we're gonna shoot a photograph. Okay, okay, let's go. Oh, we haven't taken photos, but we'll do it later. Don't worry. Yeah. Or you.